Hi, folks. Meteorologist Chris Jarzynka in for Haley LaPointe, and just in time for Super Bowl Sunday, a storm is coming in. It's a rain and snowstorm, and it's going to make for a very, very sloppy Super Bowl Sunday. It is mainly going to be rain from the Lakes region on south and east, and even in places like the Monadnock region until late in the day. But it is a plowable, wet, pasty snow well to the north and west, places like the North Country, Upper Valley. It really is a nuisance snow before noon, even in northern and western New Hampshire. The precipitation intensity will pick up after noon, and by the time the storm moves away tomorrow night and into the wee hours of Monday morning, there could be plowable amounts of 3 to 5 inches of snow in the North Country, higher terrain in the Plymouth-Rumney area, and through parts of the Upper Valley as you get a little bit of backlash. More on that in a second. The storm is actually sitting off to our west right now and is moving in very quickly during the overnight hours. The skies will click the cloud over. This is only one part of the storm, though. The storm is actually in two parts right now. The second part is hanging out towards Louisiana. Maybe a little Mardi Gras celebration? I don't know. I'm not a storm. I suppose I could ask. Don't think I get a response, though. Hey, it's chilly in Minneapolis right now, but this weather, zero in Bismarck, is going to be in Minneapolis for the Super Bowl tomorrow. It is going to be freezing standing outside. Meanwhile, it's not exactly very mild here either. As you can see, temperatures are chilly, and that sets the stage for this mixed precipitation event that we have coming in. Not going to be a huge storm. Storm number two is sitting in air that's very, very mild. In fact, it was in the 70s in Texas today. Not going to be in the 70s here, but that leads me to believe that the warm air is going to win out, and we are going to see more rain than snow for most of New Hampshire for most of the storm. It does start to snow, though. The air is simply cold enough, even though it doesn't get much colder tonight. And that's indicated by these blues. The darker blues indicate where the heavier snow is, and you can see by even tomorrow morning at 10, it's pretty much off to our west and through the Adirondacks, not here in New Hampshire. Maybe a little bit steadier in Vermont. It is afternoon into 1 o'clock in the afternoon. That's when things start to fill in and start to pick up and become steadier. But by that time, the milder weather from the south has already worked into places like Keene, Manchester, Rochester, so if it's doing anything, it's probably rain. You might see a few flakes of snow beforehand. Now, the snow will accumulate a little bit, especially off to the north and west, but as you can see in places like the Lakes region, the Upper Valley, especially through the Lower Valley, Monadnock region, and all through Manchester, Nashua, out to the seacoast, and even well up into the Lakes region on the eastern side at least, into Conway, we're talking mainly rain. The pink area is the dividing line between the two, where there could be a mix of snow and rain, but I don't see freezing rain or sleet being a big issue with this storm in that transition area. How much snow are we talking about? Well, by 2 o'clock in the afternoon, if you're doing anything in the morning, not much. In fact, south and east of Concord, nothing, and even north and west of there, it's a slushy coating, and the temperatures are going to be near freezing, so treated roads, well-traveled roads should be fine. Even by 7 o'clock at night, we've only got an inch in most places where it is snowing, and a lot of that gets washed away south and east of the Lakes region. As the storm pulls away, though, tomorrow night, the backlash, at least in northern and western New Hampshire, could bring in cold enough air for there to be an accumulation of another few inches. That would give you the 3 to 5 inch snowfall amounts that I'm thinking, at least in northern and western areas, especially in the higher terrain. South and east of there, little to nothing. Very, very little impact. And even the rain itself won't be that heavy for flooding or anything like that. Overnight tonight, clouds thicken and lower. It'll be chilly. Lows dropping 9 to 19 degrees above zero, but that's pretty much where they are for most of the evening. So we're not going to see the temperatures falling off all that much. For Super Bowl Sunday, any sunshine early on gets sacked, pardon the pun. Wet snow arriving mainly in the afternoon, although we will have that nuisance snow in the morning north and west. It is a very quick change to rain in southern New Hampshire as temperatures shoot through the 30s, and areas near the seacoast and the Mass border could actually be warmer than 40. But you see, that warm air only gets so far, and that backlash is what's going to give us the opportunity for snow north and west of the Lakes region and into the North Country. After that storm moves away, blustery and chilly weather, but not frigid for Monday. It'll feel colder than 34, snow showers in the mountains. A bright and rather calm day on Tuesday. Another storm, again, not a huge one, moves in for Wednesday. Originally, that looked like that was mainly going to be a big wet snowstorm. Now it looks like mild enough air could get in that it's going to be rain once again in central and southern New Hampshire. That storm moves away and it's blustery once again with mountain snow showers on Thursday. Again, a calmer day on Friday, maybe a little light snow up north. And then yet another storm comes in for late on Saturday into Sunday. The meteorologist dance card is full, folks, sorry to say. Thanks very much for clicking on this WMUR Weather on the Web videocast.